If woman can survive, they may find. Everything you think, do, and say is in the bill you just do today. In the year 45, you gonna eat your teeth, won't eat your eyes. You won't mind the things you choose. Nobody's gonna look at you. In the year 55, your arms are hanging limp at your side.
with us. You are not in the clinic. We are in the clinic. Okay, fair enough.
And that's four times now. Four times, 4 minutes. Right on pace. You said you only counted two. Remember any times you misled us? You weren't counting. You were misleading. Again, number four.
I am sorry to have misled you, Jessica. I will try to be more careful in the future.
Let's call it even, Dr. Carmington.
Okay, deal. How does everyone else feel about this? Autumn? Heidi, do you feel misled?
No. I think she's being too sensitive, Dr. Carmington. She's not being receptive to your messages. She's not open to the help only the clinic can provide. Dr. Covington is only trying to help you. He helped me. He cured me.
Oh? Well, thanks for the endorsement. What were you cured of, Heidi?
You cured me. The clinic cured me.
What did you have?
An infection.
A virus?
Evil.
Ooh, scary.
You know what I did. You all know what I did. You know what I'm capable of.
We're capable of?
Yes, of course. What I was capable of before the clinic.
Sweet. What kind of meds you been shooting her up with, Doc?
Andy, you know that information is kept in confidence. I cannot share her medication schedule with you. Now, if Heidi would like to discuss her medication with you, well, she is welcome.
So, Heidi, what have they been injecting your brain with this week? Extra doses of Thorazine?
It was Dr. Covington. Dr. Covington cured me. The clinic cured me.
To be cured, you have to have disease.
I was evil. That's disease enough. But the clinic cured me.
Ooh, I was evil, but the clinic cured me. Ooh! She's one flew over the cuckoo's nest.
Oh, I love jackass. A few good men. Hoffa. Shining. As good as it gets. Batman. Turns into German.
Edward, did you just say something?
Yes.
Yes, you did, fruitcake.
You were mumbling Jack Nicholson movies.
I did think I heard you say something just there, Edward. Would you like to tell us why you're here?
You know why I'm here.
Well, why didn't you refresh my memory?
Them. Reporter. The man. We're always watching. In the car, in the shower, in your dreams, and in the clinic.
Do you mean the government? Is the government always watching you, Edward?
All the leaders are watching. Because you can't see them doesn't mean they're not there. I can see them right here. Right here in this clinic. Right behind this wall. They're watching.
Why you, Edward? Why are they watching you? Well, why not me? Or Andy here? Or Jessica? Or Nurse Francis?
We'll talk about Nurse Francis. Okay. They're watching all of us. All of us in the class. They're watching.
You can see them? What are they doing right now?
I'm wondering about the girl with no legs. They're staring at her.
Karen, I think Edward is referring to you. Would you like to share with us and everyone watching through the wall there why you are in the clinic?
Sorry to interrupt, Dr. Covington. May I speak with you for a second?
Certainly, Doctor.